Today we're with Dr. Gerry Pinto, who's a manatee researcher at Jacksonville University. Hey, Dr. Pinto.
Hi, Lucas. I have a manatee rib bone for you today.
Okay.
So here it is. If you can imagine, that's what it looks like on these skeleton behind us.
Wow, that's really heavy.
It is heavy. And that's due to the fact that it doesn't have any marrow in it.
Okay. It's solid.
And it's solid. It's more mineralized. It has probably about 10% more mineralization than regular human bones or cow bones. It's heavy, and it's supposed to be heavy because it allows manatees to sink down in the water easier.
Okay. Kind of like control their buoyancy.
Exactly. Okay. Just like a diver has a weight belt.
Okay. Yeah.
The weight
is
used similarly. Here's a dolphin bone. Feel how heavy that is.
I can light. Raise it up. Yeah, it's really light.
Okay. Light as a feather, and this has marrow in it, and it's very much more spongy, and actually has better shock absorption properties than the manatee bone, which is like a rock, almost ceramic. And so the manatee bone is actually less strong. It would shatter easier.
Okay. So if it was hit by something.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Here's an interesting manatee bone.
Holy cow.
That is a rib bone.
Okay.
Obviously experienced some kind of blunt trauma, whether it was from a jet ski, a personal watercraft, a boat of some kind, and the rib broke off and reattached in the wrong place. Instead of down here, it's reattached up here.
Really? Okay. So that's typically why you would get a cast or screws or anything when you break your arm to help place the bone where it's supposed to heal so it doesn't fuse like that.
Right.
Okay.
Yeah. One of the leading causes of human-caused manatee deaths are boat strikes.
Really?
One out of five or six in the state is a watercraft death. So when I'm flying above Jacksonville looking for manatees and counting them as part of my research studies, I see them along the shorelines for the most part. It's a shallow area. Okay. It's easier to count them and see them there. But you'll notice also in Duval County there are a lot of speed zone signs that are there to protect manatees. Mm-hmm. We call them manatee speed zones. And there will be a big orange circle with a warning. And those signs tell boaters to slow down so that manatees have a chance to get away and not get hit by boats. Makes sense.
Manatees have been in these waters long before we've had boats. So when you're out boating, be sure to keep an eye out for the signs and the manatees so you know when to slow down. Give the manatees a little bit of extra time to swim away.
FWC loans us these bones, and we can use them for educational purposes to teach people about boat strikes and manatees. Actually, holding those bones in your hands allows you to make that connection.